Hi everyone, I'm Brian with the Scientist in Every Florida School program. And in this edition of Science Segments, I'm excited to connect you to a scientist to help you learn about astronomy. Who are you and what is your title?
Hi there, I am Clara Sousa-Silva and I am a molecular astrophysicist at MIT.
What do you research and why is that important?
So I spend most of my time trying to figure out what gases life produces and then looking at how those gases affect the atmosphere. And then I figure out how to look at those atmospheres on alien planets to figure out if they have life on them. And it's important because it's really, really cool. And it would be really nice to understand if and how life exists on other planets.
What are the various methods of measuring astronomical distances and how do scientists use them?
We as astronomers have many ways of measuring distances. Everything is very far away and we can't just go there and, you know, measure them with a ruler. And so when things are reasonably near, like the moon or Jupiter, we can use radar. And the way that works is we send signals onto anything and then the signals bounce back and we look at how long it took for the signals to get there and come back and we'll figure out how far away things are. So for example, the Apollo astronauts left a bunch of really, really shiny mirrors on the moon. And so we can send signals onto those mirrors on the moon. And when the signals come back, we can find out exactly how far the moon is at that exact moment. And so we can use this system of bouncing signals off things for things that aren't too far away. So all the way to the edge of the solar system. We can't bounce things off faraway stars. It would take many years for the signals to come back. And so for things outside the solar system, so other stars in the galaxy, for example, we use a different system called parallax. And parallax is used in all sorts of things, but it relies on the fact that whenever you move your head, things seem to move in the distance. So you can put your thumb in front of your face and then close one eye and then close the other eye and you'll see your thumb moved a bit. And then if you put your thumb far away and you do the same thing, your thumb moved a little bit less. And so if you could put your thumb far, far, far away, it would move even less. And you can tell by how far your thumb moves, how far away something is. And so we use this system for stars in our galaxy, and we see how far they move, and we can tell how far away they are. But of course, when the stars are really, really, really far away, they move very little. And so it's hard to tell if they moved at all. So for stars outside our galaxy, we use something called standard candles, by which we mean things that we already know how bright they are. Things like Cepheid stars, which were discovered by an amazing astronomer called Henrietta Leavitt in like, I don't know, 19 a little. And she found out that there were these special stars called Cepheids, but there's others called supernova, that we know exactly how bright they should be. And so when we find these stars, even in other galaxies, and we see how dim they look, we can guess how far away they must be. And so these standard candles are how we look at really far away things. And finally, and I don't know if this is part of your curriculum, but finally, when things are really, 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 really far away, so galaxies far, far away, everything's so dim and it's so hard to see that it's hard to use these standard candles, these Cepheid stars or supernovas. So instead we use something we already know, which is a theory of how the universe behaves. And we know the universe expands and expands very fast. And the further things are, the faster they expand. And so we look at how fast something is moving away from us and we can guess how far away it is. And this is a very special rule that comes from a very impressive theory that basically found that everything in the universe is moving further and further away from one another, ever faster. And this is a recent theory. When I was your age, we were just figuring it out. And so we're still figuring it out. But for the very, very far away things, we use that. How fast are they moving? That tells us how far away they are. And that's how we measure distances as astronomers.
Thank you, Dr. Sousa-Silva. And thank you all so much for watching. If you have any questions, you may reach out through her contact information in the description down below. We will see you next time.